Hi, I'm Troy from Studio 33 Guitar. Thanks for watching. Today we're having a look at a classic rock song, Ozzy Osbourne's Crazy Train, featuring the great guitar player, Randy Rhoads. This song has an instantly recognizable guitar riff at the beginning that's a lot of fun to play, and it also uses some different chord shapes in the verse that you might not be familiar with, but they're great to add to your knowledge of chords because they can be used in a lot of other songs as well. As always, if you like this video, then please let us know by clicking on the like button, subscribing to the channel, and leaving a comment down below. That'll help us to make more videos like this. Also, don't forget to check us out on all the social media sites. We're there under Studio 33 Guitar. So let's zoom in on the neck and have a look at how we play Crazy Train. The intro of this song starts with an F sharp power chord. So the first note you need is an F sharp. That's going to be played with your index finger on the second fret of the E string. And a power chord only has two notes. So you need a note that's called the fifth above. The fifth is always located one string down and two frets over. So you can either play that with your ring finger like that, or you can play it with your pinky, which is usually what I do because I find the stretch is a little bit less. But it's those two notes together that you need. So you don't need to play the other strings, it's just those two, and that gives you a power chord. So we start with that F sharp chord for the intro, and he hits that twice like this. Okay, now after you hit that note, you want to mute it. Now you can use your picking hand to rest against the strings, which is what I just did there. And at the same time, I lightly lift my fingers off the notes for this hand. Now you don't want to lift your fingers completely off the strings, but you just want to ease off the pressure. So both hands are working together to mute those notes. So we start with that F sharp twice. And then we're gonna go up to an A power chord. So our index finger is gonna go up to the A. And again, we're gonna stay in that same position, one string down, two frets over. And that'll give you an A power chord. We're gonna hit that twice. And then we're gonna go immediately to an open E string power chord. So for that one, we're gonna play the open E, and then our index finger is going to go right here on this second fret of the A string. We're gonna hit that twice. So that whole thing together would be, and then back to the F sharp. And now we're gonna go up to a D power chord. So the D note is the fifth fret on the A string. And then again, that same position. And now we're gonna go up to a high E, which is two frets up. Okay, so that whole thing together sounds like this. And then that entire sequence is repeated exactly the same one more time. After the second time through those chords, we move on to the main riff of the intro. And that's gonna look like this. The main riff starts on the same F sharp note that we're using for the power chord. And we're gonna be bouncing back and forth between this F sharp note and some other notes. So it starts with the F sharp two times, and then you're gonna go to that same note we were using for the power chord, and it's a good idea for this riff to use your ring finger now, not your pinky. So you're gonna have the F sharp twice, that C sharp note, and then back to the F sharp. So that'll be. Then you're gonna go with your pinky finger up to this D note, back to the F sharp again, and then back to that C sharp again. So far we have this. Go back to that F sharp note. Now we're gonna move down to this B note down here. And we're gonna play to the open A, and then to the ring finger up on this note. Back to the open A. So let's put that together so far. And you repeat that. Now we're gonna play an open E. Back to the F sharp. Okay, so let's take a look at that whole thing together. repeat that riff again. Now that open A string can be played with this note up here instead. And I've seen it done that way as well. I prefer to use the open A string. I just find it's a little bit easier to play, but you can use this note. So instead that would look like this. So if you find that playing that note instead of the open string, you can do it that way as well. Or. And that's the whole riff. Now, it might take a little bit of time to get that together. Just take it slow and eventually just build up the speed to get it to the right tempo. And that riff is played a total of 4 times through the intro. Now on the 4th time, you're gonna do it just a little bit differently. You're gonna cut it a little bit short and you're gonna throw in a D power chord and an E power chord. That's gonna sound like this. And that brings us to the verse section of the song. And in the intro, I talked about how there's a couple of different chord voicings in here that you might not be familiar with, but they're great to know, and you can use them in a lot of different situations. The first chord that we need for the verse is an A major chord, and we're gonna play that like this. Now, the fingering for this is actually part of an A major bar chord, if you know how to play that. But the fingers that we're using, we're only using 3 fingers to play these 3 notes. So instead of playing the full bar chord. So we have our ring finger on an A note that is on the 7th fret of the D string. And then our middle finger is 1 string down and just 1 fret back. And then the index finger is 1 more string down and 1 fret back. And then we're gonna play this open A string as well. So that's gonna be 4 notes altogether. It's gonna sound like this. Now what's good to know about this chord shape is the root note is that ring finger. So right now we're on an A note. So it's good to know that you could move that shape around. If you wanted to play a B major chord, you could just slide that up. As long as your ring finger is on B, then you would have a B chord there. Or if you wanted to do it in G, you could do it down here. So it's a good little chord shape to know. Now, if you're playing the G or B or any other ones, you wouldn't want to have that A string ringing open like we did for the A chord. But you can know that that shape is one that you can move all around, up and down the neck, and whatever note your ring finger is on is your root note. The next chord that we're going to need is actually an E chord, and it might look a little different as well, and it's going to be played like this. So what we've done for this chord is, if we go back to this A, we just moved the ring finger on the same string, we moved it down 1 fret. And now we've kind of reversed our index and middle finger for the strings that they're on. So the middle finger comes down and goes on this E note, which is the 5th fret of the B string. And the index finger is on the 4th fret, 1 string up on the G. So those 3 notes together give you an E chord. Again, this is a really useful chord shape that you can use all over the neck. Now in this case, the middle finger is the root note. So right now that is an E chord. And we're gonna use this same shape for the next chord for the verse. We're gonna slide that shape down 2 frets. And now we're playing a D chord because now our middle finger is on a D note. So again, wherever we move that shape, whatever note your middle finger is on would be the chord. So it's a good shape to know. Now, if you want to know a little bit more theory about this chord, it's actually what's called an inverted chord. This note that's being held down with our ring finger is actually the same note that would normally be played in a regular D chord by our middle finger. So in this case, what we're doing is we're putting that highest note that's being played with the middle finger and we're moving it down to this position here. So our fingering just changes and that finger comes up here, and that is still a D chord, but now this note, which is an F sharp, is in the bass. After we play that D chord, now we're gonna go to a regular A power chord, which is gonna be played with our index finger barring across here. So we have the open A string, and then all we need is just this first note here, but you can also bar across and get the octave there, and that gives you the A chord. For all those chords, the A, E, D, and A again, we're gonna let that A string ring open the entire time. The rhythm of the verse has a little bit of a galloping kind of a feel to it, which is quite interesting. So we're gonna start out by playing that open A string three times with this kind of a rhythm. And then we're gonna hit that chord. So together that would sound like this. And then we're gonna slide down to our E shape, and we're gonna keep that open A string going. We're gonna hit it a couple more times. And then a couple more times again. A couple more again to the A. Once we hit that A chord, we're gonna reach up with the ring finger and grab this G sharp note. Back to the A chord. So altogether, that's gonna sound like this. So that's it for this lesson. I hope that you enjoyed that. I think that that opening riff is gonna be a lot of fun for you to play. And again, those verse chords are really good chord shapes to use in a lot of different situations. So make sure that you practice those and understand where the root notes are so you can move them around and use them in different songs. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.